Good evening, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. At 1:44 Pacific Standard Time, there by the city of Walker, there was a magnitude 4.4 earthquake that so far 216 people said they felt. Here we have the moment tensor ball. The earthquake came straight up and we got spreading. Kind of like a mound, you know, when you push up on the ground, it's going to spread out, and that's what happened here. USGS is reporting 8 earthquakes so far. Here's the location of that 4.4. Yeah, they didn't fudge about it. All right, so we got some different earthquakes marked out here. In 2021, there was a 4.6, a 5.0. Let's see here. Oh, and a 6.0 in 2021 last year. That was July 8th. Yeah. Interesting, because today is August 8th, 2022. Here's an image of the spectrogram for that earthquake. What they did was add in all kinds of little shocks that occurred with this earthquake. This one here. This one here, that one there, that one there, that one there, and that one there. Let's go to the seismic signature. I'll have to make it bigger for you. Okay. All right, there's the first initial earthquake as it came in from the monitor that I'm using. Oh, I hate that when it goes little on me. Okay, there's the second one. And the next one, I'll have to make it larger again. Oops, there's the next one. Anyways, they added all these in together. Here's the felt reports. It was felt as far as San Mateo. Yeah. Oakland. What else we got down here? Merced. San Luis Reservoir. That was intensity level 2. Up over here, Mariposa, intensity level 4. Let's see here, Waterford, intensity level 4. Yeah, that's surprising how it's so widely felt with an intensity level of 4. Yeah, we got Santa Rosa. Lake Oroville. It was a very shallow earthquake, only 3.4 miles in depth. Looks like all of them have between 3, close to 4. They've all been shallow. Intensity level 4 means it was felt indoors by many people, outdoors by a few at night, or if they were napping, because it was in the afternoon. They would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, doors disturbed, and automobiles would have been rocking noticeably. So extracting, making larger the seismic wave, it looks like it's all tectonic in movement. Yeah, the fault line moved. That's probably why they measured it for so long. And yeah, the fault line opened up more recently. Let's see, what do we got right here? This is when I pulled the files. Okay, 2336, that's universal time. They're not reporting that earthquake. That comes in as a magnitude 62. That's what it was, 2.62. It just cleared on me for some reason. This here is the stream view, and you can see lots of earthquakes here. This is the last 3 hours. That's an interesting little signature there. I made it bigger. Okay, 2327. I think that very well could be it. I want to go to the signature and see what we got here. Yeah, just more tectonic. This is all part of the Walker Lane fault zone. The monitor that I'm using is over here, drawn out in red. or yellow, excuse me. It's the Ebbets Pass stratovolcano. I'll give you a link to this paper. It says this region has been described as the northernmost extension of the Gulf of California transitional rift, where the process of continental rupture has not yet been completed. And I talked about how the Walker Lane accommodates between 20-30% of the right lateral motion between the Pacific and the North American plates. The San Andreas Fault accommodates the rest. This area is one of two areas of volcanic centers. This one here and the other one, the Long Valley Volcanic Center. Yeah, one day this is going to be the major fault system. Yeah, when the San Andreas Fault gets done and falls into the ocean and people have beachfront property. Evidently, the Walker Lane is about 100 kilometers or 60 miles wide. Yeah, that's a wide area of ripping apart, isn't it? Yeah, and up over here, we got Lake Tahoe. So just taking a wild guess from this Ebbets volcano all the way over to Walker Lake, that's about 60 miles. Give you an idea how wide this area is for faulting, rifting apart. So have you felt this earthquake? Like I said, there's been last year a 6.0 in this same location. Yeah, I would be prepared for more earthquakes and large earthquakes, more damage. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.